Driving any data-driven business to success is possible by making use of concepts such as data science and machine learning. Many companies, from the startups to the Fortune 500s like Apple, Microsoft, Google, and many others, go on to use these concepts on a daily basis for their needs. And in this session, we're going to compare data science and machine learning head-on. Well, before we begin with the session, make sure to subscribe to the Intellipaat YouTube channel and hit the bell icon so that you never miss an update from us. Here's the agenda for today. We'll have a quick introduction to what data science actually is and understand data science basically. And after this, we're going to have an introduction to machine learning and see where machine learning is used and much, much more. And after this, we're going to have an in-depth comparison considering a lot of factors about data science and machine learning and see how both of it holds its ground together as well. And after this, guys, if you have any queries, make sure to head down to the comment section and do let us know, and we'll be happy to help you out. And in case if you guys are looking for end-to-end course certification in data science, Intellipaat provides the Data Science Architect Master's program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same as well. So without further ado, let's begin the class. Coming to the first point on the agenda, it is introduction to data science. We need to understand what data science is, guys. Here's a quick overview on it. So basically, data science is nothing but a multidisciplinary field, focus on the multidisciplinary word, basically, which helps in finding actionable insights from large sets of raw data and structured and unstructured data at the same time. So when you have to talk about data science, it basically, you know, takes an unruly entity, a raw entity such as data, and converts it into something valuable, something useful, for example, information. So this process of converting data into information and doing it in the very efficient way is basically one of the goals of data science. And you know, the main goal, if you have to talk about a data scientist perspective, is to basically ask questions on the data to pretty much, you know, find out where all the data can be studied from, basically potential avenues of study, and pretty much, you know, get answers to specific questions and ensure that you know when and where to ask the right question and to ask the perfect question which fits that scenario regarding whatever data aspects we're talking about. And this skill of asking the right question, this skill of finding out something about your data which might not be present for the naked eye, is one of the biggest goals, one of the biggest skills in fact to have as a data scientist. So if you have to talk about data is considered to be the new oil, because we all know how much worth oil is, right? So data, it's pretty much is the biggest component in today's world of technology. And this is because everyone understood the potential of data. Everyone understood what data can actually pretty much drive for their businesses. Driving them to success is one of the biggest aspect of it. Getting good insights, predicting the future, and performing analytics, and much, much more. And at the end of the day, this will, of course, increase profitability by somehow for all these companies which have been using. And that could be one of the main reasons why data is in the spotlight today. And to quickly talk about the impact of data science, we've seen companies such as Apple, and we have Tesla. So Tesla has the self-driving autonomous cars, and Apple has Siri. Siri is a chatbot. And when you go on to learn more about these concepts, or when you go on to practically use them, you understand that these concepts are such beautiful innovations of today's world. They make use of concepts such as machine learning, artificial intelligence, and all of these comes in fact under the umbrella of data science as well. And I read about the practical use case of detection of breast cancer, which happened as an experiment in 2019, where a lot of researchers actually detected about a 50% chance of predicting premature breast cancer. And trust me, 50% is a huge number when you have to talk about anything in the field of medicine. Now let's talk about an airline, for example. Southwest Airlines is again a very good airline which runs throughout the United States. So these guys saved $100 million by basically analyzing how long their planes actually waited with their engines on before taking off. And pretty much they could come down by a number of $100 million. That's a huge saving for an airline, right? Then when you have to talk about UPS, UPS basically saved 39 million gallons of fuel by just optimizing how they deliver packages. So UPS is basically a very famous package delivery service across the world, and a courier service, to be honest. So these guys analyzed the routes, probably rerouted it very efficiently to understand how better can they produce routes, how better can they actually follow along by delivering packages. And they saved 39 million gallons of fuel, ladies and gentlemen. And if we have to talk about a quick introduction to machine learning, well, what is machine learning is the first question you're supposed to ask. Well, you know, machine learning is an application of artificial intelligence to begin with, of course, because at the end of the day, machine learning, whenever we talk anything about machine learning, it is to achieve AI on certain level. It might be weak AI, it might be strong AI, or whatever it is. So machine learning basically, you know, provides computers the capability to learn on their own and to improve with the experience that they've been using to learn. And all of this is done without basically programming them. Just a quick info, guys. In case you guys are planning to have an end-to-end course certification in data science, Intellipaat provides the Data Science Architect Master's program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same as well. The link is in the description box, so make sure to check it out. And on that note, let's get back to the session. And if you have to talk about machine learning right now, well, right now it basically is a lot of usage of algorithms, mathematics, and statistics, and all of these on steroids. But in the future, machine learning will be all about achieving artificial intelligence. As I just told you, even right now, we are striving very close to it. But here, when we have to talk about cognition and achieving artificial intelligence as a whole, we compare this to human level intelligence and then work with it. And of course, this future is very foreseeable. It's very near, and probably by the end of this decade, we will have multiple revolutionary concepts, multiple revolutionary tools and techniques which will basically help mankind to, you know, get one step closer to artificial intelligence. So there are multiple machine learning applications around us. If we look, so we have voice recognition, we have social media, we have video surveillance, malware and spam detection, predictions, and many other usages as well. If you have to talk about voice recognition, again, voice unlock is a very famous use case of machine learning. Then if you talk about social media, Facebook has auto, pretty much it recognizes your face automatically. Then Instagram knows what ads it's supposed to show you. Twitter pretty much analyzes the sentiments of the tweet. Vimeo, YouTube, Skype, all of these guys make use of machine learning on a daily basis. If you have to talk about video surveillance, think about automated traffic fines system where, you know, there doesn't have to be a cop, there doesn't have to be a policeman, finding people who are violating the traffic rules. It might just be a camera which is smart enough, which has a very good framework, and it can pretty much capture people who are, going against the rules and fine them automatically. And then you have to talk about malware and spam. So how does, for example, let me take the example of Gmail. So how does Google know what mail is spam, what mail is contains a malware, and all what mail is it supposed to give it to your inbox? So priority inbox as well. So when you have to talk about this again, yes, machine learning is being used here for a really, really long time, but it was so subtle pretty much that we couldn't notice. And then you have to talk about predictions of the future. Of course, there's this concept called as data analytics, where we use the present data to basically analyze, understand, and plot a data in the future timeline. So that again is a very good use case of machine learning as well. If there is anything else, do head to the comment sections and do let us know. And of course, here are some of the key moments in machine learning history. In 2012, Google came out with Google Brain. And then DeepMind. DeepMind basically is a brainchild of Google, where it could play games at a mind-blowing level. It could analyze millions and millions of steps in a game every single second as well. Then in 2014, we got DeepFace. DeepFace was basically Facebook's brainchild, and they pretty much wanted to implement deep learning for face recognition, as I just told you a few slides back. Then of course, AlphaGo. AlphaGo is basically similar to DeepMind. It was part of a program under Google DeepMind, where there was a game called as Go, and a machine was pretty much put into place where it defeated the world champion of the game Go multiple times, and Go is considered to be the toughest board game in the entire world. So it was predicting about a million times faster than the human being, a million, yes, and this was every second. So, you know, humans cannot think that fast every single second, so this just goes on a very exponential scale with every second passing. So now coming to the direct head-on between data science and machine learning. The first point we'll be discussing is the meaning. So data science, it is basically a field where data, any type of data, structured data, unstructured data, semi-structured data, it goes through a process of being cleaned, filtered, and basically analyzed. And all of this is done to ensure there is something useful which can be put out in the other end of it, and that result can be used effectively as well. So that's data science. Coming to machine learning is actually a part of data science.
which makes use of multiple tools, multiple techniques out there, which creates beautiful algorithms. So these algorithms are the basic foundation, the fundamental aspect of where and how a machine can learn from data by making use of the experience. Then coming to second point, it is the scope. When you talk about the scope, again, data science has a vast scope because, you know, if you talk about it in a single dimension in today's world, data science has been everywhere. It has a foot which is so strongly put in the world of data that, you know, every company which is driven by data uses data science in one way or the other. Then when you have to talk about machine learning, is basically a part of data science, as I told you. And of course, it is this part that it pretty much talks to. It is the data modeling stage. So once the data modeling stage is completed, the machine learning part of data science will be done. And this again is one of the very most important differences between data science and machine learning. When you have to talk about the third point, it is methodologies. Of course, data science works with multiple manual methodologies, but when you have to talk about making a machine efficient, but comparing it directly to a machine which makes of algorithms, data science lacks a little. And machine learning, of course, cannot exist without data science. And all of these data which machine learning algorithms use to work so efficiently have to come from all the other data science concepts, to where, you know, models are basically preconditioned, pre-treated, data cleansing is done, the data preparation is done, and then later these algorithms are basically applied to create a model, to train these models, to test if it's working, to optimize it, and further on. Coming to point number four, it's the goal of these technologies. So basically, as you already might know, data science, you know, helps you to define new problems that actually need to be solved in today's world. So instead of giving a direct solution to all the problems which already exist, this will define new problems, and these new problems have a point of answering, and this answer comes from machine learning, all the techniques of machine learning, all the statistical analytics methodologies, and much more. And of course, machine learning, you know, it knows how the problem is sorted out, and pretty much it helps in giving the solution to the problem. It has all the tools that is needed, all the techniques that is needed to basically generate models around the problem and to solve the same. Coming to point number five, it's prerequisite. To understand data science, you know, there is a prerequisite of understanding SQL. SQL is structured query language, and this is needed because when you work with data, you'll be talking to databases. If you have to talk to databases, if you have to talk to your data present in the databases, you need to understand how you can create tables, create databases, work with your data, alter your data, delete your data, and much more. SQL helps just there. When you talk about machine learning requires a bit of programming in depth, because languages such as Python, R, Java, Lisp, all of these concepts are the ones which basically implement the mathematical concepts, the statistical concepts, and which provide the foundation to, basically help the machine understand the mathematical algorithms on which it has to use these concepts and work on. Point number six is the actual process. So data science, you know, is basically a complete package. It is a complete process which involves a lot of things. As I told you, everything from data cleansing to data analysis comes in the field of data science. But when you have to talk about machine learning is just one part in this huge world of data science, guys. Then coming to the next point, which is basically the average salary. Data scientists get an average salary of somewhere around $130,000 American dollars per annum. But then when you have to talk about machine learning engineers also get a very attractive compensation of somewhere about $124,000 American dollars per annum as well. So these both are very lucrative careers, and they pay really well, and they are among the top jobs in today's world. Then when you have to talk about the companies which go on to use these technologies, let's talk about data science. You know, everyone from Unisys, IBM, Fractal Analytics, we have EY, Ernst & Young, Edgeworth, Mu Sigma, Ola, Siemens, Oracle, Truecaller, and thousands of other companies basically go on to use data science for their daily needs. Coming to machine learning in today's world has a very strong holding in the social media industry. You know, everyone from Instagram, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Viber, WhatsApp, Evernote, Android, of course, brainchild of Google. We have Twitter, WeChat, Facebook. I can, you know, pretty much name everything out there. But then these are the main aspects where experiments were tried out a couple of years ago of using machine learning most efficiently. And as per a survey conducted in 2015, pretty much machine learning was used the most efficiently in the world of social media. And you know, there are other companies as well. There's Adobe, Best Buy, Apple, Walmart, Google, BBC, Skype, and of course, thousands and thousands of other companies, and all the Fortune 500 companies pretty much go on to use machine learning in one way or the other. To basically summarize this discussion, I would like to tell you two things. One of that is that data science has been rightfully called as a new oil in today's world of information, because again, having data is like having wealth if you understand how you can use it. Think about crude oil. You cannot put crude oil in your vehicles as it is. It has to be converted into petroleum, into diesel and whatnot, right? So data science is just the tool which basically does exactly this when we have to talk about this analogy with respect to data. Then coming to machine learning, of course, machine learning has absolutely revolutionized the way we make use of computers, the way we treat data, the way we understand data, and the way we go on to make data work for us. So these two are very lucrative careers. They are the top jobs in today's world, and of course they are very magical to learn, to understand, and of course to build a career in. So on that note, you've reached the end of this comparison.
Just a quick info, guys. In case you guys are planning to have an end-to-end course certification in data science, Intellipaat provides the Data Science Architect Master's program where you can learn all of these concepts thoroughly and earn a certificate in the same as well. The link is in the description box, so make sure to check it out. Hope you guys enjoyed this video and got to learn a lot from the same as well. If you have any queries or if you have any more points you want to add to this versus video, make sure to head down to the comment section and do it now. We'll be happy to help you there and reply at the earliest. And on that note, have a nice day.